James, let's first look back on Sunday's 10-try, 64-point victory over Plymouth. Was that the perfect response after defeat to Bristol the week before?
Well, we took a calculated risk against Bristol. We took the opportunity to rest a few boys, and we targeted a certain amount of points from the first five games, and we've exceeded that. So we know the league is a marathon rather than a sprint. We're really pleased the boys went out and got 5 points on Sunday and scored 10 tries. I mean, it's a fantastic effort. The second half, the boys really came together, and they earned the right to play with the ball. The ball was going to hand. We were getting the majority of the bounces, and the opportunity to play arose, and the boys really, really dug in. And I mean, the last try, it was on to play, and the boys played and they scored, and it's fantastic.
Was it the most complete performance since you've joined the club?
The second half was. We've been at a couple of good performances since I've been here. But in terms of everything coming together over 40 minutes, certainly. And the boys had to defend really well because Plymouth wanted to play with the ball. And the attacking, I mean, some of the offloading was fantastic. We've got to be clear that other days maybe a few of those passes wouldn't have gone to hand, but on Sunday, like I said, everything just clicked. So the guys are buoyant from it. I mean, we're by no means whatsoever perfect. We've still got a lot of work to do, and we had two humdingers against Ponty last year, and the boys have come back down to earth now, and they know that there's going to be one hell of a game down in the House of Pain on Saturday.
How important was it for the backs to show off their skills on Sunday? I mean, a lot's been made about the physical attributes of our forward pack this season, but the backs really performed superbly on Sunday.
Our forwards have benefited from the backs putting them in position, and it's very much a team game. And you know, some of the tries the boys scored across the board, the backs who dotted the ball down, Mark Bright offloading, Neil Best offloading, James Phillips making dents down the middle. So you know, the opportunity to play arose, and 1-15, the boys are fantastic. Really pleased with Lee Miller. Quite an unsung hero for us, and for him to get MOM and not only to defend well and score a couple of great tries, he kicked really well. And we talked about our green zone discipline, and even on 73 minutes, the boys could have been tempted into throwing the ball around when it wasn't on, but they didn't. You know, they executed what we've asked them to do and made the most of the opportunities that were there, and they didn't force anything, and scored 10 good tries.
Let's look ahead to this weekend. As you said, we've got Pontypeed away from home. Are you looking to make an impact in this competition this season?
Me? I'm not playing. It's a competition we think a lot of. It's obviously great for us in as much as we get to play different opposition. We got to play Ponty twice last year, and like I already said, they were two really tough games. Ponty are probably the Welsh Premiership team that really, really go in for the competition. They'll be looking to really stick it to us, I'm sure. I mean, they came up last year and it was very much the best of the amateurs against a professional outfit and playing the underdog card and really wanted to put on a show. So we'll be going down there on Saturday to the House of Pain. And, you know, we had a great trip last year, even though we came off worse. It was a great, great atmosphere, and it'd be great for some of our players who haven't probably played as much rugby as they wanted to. They're going to get an opportunity this week. The boys, the challenge has been set from the Plymouth game, and it's all about trying to maintain those standards. And that's what we're looking for the squad to do.
Somewhat of a group of death with Pontypridd, Bristol and obviously Connacht in it as well.
I don't think you could pick a tougher pool, but it's brilliant. You know, we get to play Ponty, we get to play Connacht, and we get to have another go against Bristol. So, you know, it's brilliant because we've got a squad of 30 and we need all of those boys to be up to speed. We some boys have had more minutes than others, and so we've got to take the opportunity to try and rotate a few boys through the BNI window while still trying to maintain the level of performance. So the guys that are coming in this week, you know, have been wanting an opportunity, they've trained really hard, and they've got the opportunity to put their hand up.
Just finally, Conor Braid, we signed him last week. He scored 2 tries against Plymouth on Sunday. Pleased with his impact so far?
He's been fantastic since he stepped in the place. He's got a brilliant attitude. We were talking about him on Sunday before the game, just saying, you know, is this guy too good to be true? And then he went out and scored 2 tries and really contributed. So, we're really pleased to have him. Chris Auld as well has come down. And the fact that we can benefit from the relationship we've got with Glasgow and Edinburgh, it's fantastic for us. Connor's done really well. He got an opportunity to play again this week, and Chris has come in and trained really well today. So it's brilliant. What's ever so pleasing is we've got that kind of environment that guys can come straight into and with a smile on their face and get on and enjoy what they're doing. So, you know, it's great for us, but also it's brilliant. We're lucky that, you know, we've got two guys that seem to be the right sort of calibre and fit in with the boys we've got here.
Thanks for joining us.
Cheers.